पीठ पर फैलाए, प्रयोग संपन्न, समय संपन्न। ओम शांति, ओम अरहम। आप सभी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। अभी हमारे साथ डॉक्टर सुनीता मैम जुड़ गए हैं।
थैंक यू राजू। एम आई ऑडिबल? सुनाई दे रहा है? थैंक यू राजू फॉर अ वंडरफुल सेशन। और इस समय सभी जो है डायबिटिक हाइपरटेंशन वॉरियर्स, तो अ वेरी वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। एंड हाउ एवरीवन इज डूइंग? सभी का डाइट प्लान चल रहा है? आर यू फॉलोइंग द डाइट प्लान? So today's lecture, I have titled today's lecture Cure Diabetes, Hypertension, Heart Problems Naturally. If a person observes dietetic rectitude, he needs no medicine. And if he does not observe dietetic rectitude, medicine will not do any good for that person. So this we need to understand. For healthy or sick, no pathy, whether it's homeopathy, allopathy, naturopathy, it won't do anything unless and until you inculcate some dietary modification in your diet. Ancient holy texts have also said, yukt ahar viharasse, yukt cheshtasse karmasu, युक्त स्वप्न बोध से योगो भवति दुखा। अर्थात ही हु इज मॉडरेट एंड डिसिप्लिन्ड इन फूड रिक्रिएशन, हु इज मॉडरेट इन वर्क एंड स्लीप एंड वेकफुलनेस अटेन्स योगिक स्टेट, दैट इज फिजिकल मेंटल स्पिरिचुअल हेल्थ, दैट इज होलिस्टिक हेल्थ। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड homeostasis. Our body is a fantastic, it has a fantastic mechanism, and it has a mechanism called homeostasis, which is the dynamic equilibrium. Our body's tendency to maintain stable equilibrium between interdependent elements, especially as maintained by physiological processes, neuro, endocrine, digestive, respiratory. For example, when it's summer, by sweating, the body tries to maintain the normal body temperature. In winter, when it is cold, the body shivers. This is like body's ability to cope up with the outside environmental conditions and adjust accordingly and maintain a stable parameters, all the parameters, whether it is temperature, sugar, BP, and diet religiously. Because what I am suggesting is, like, if you follow the more than 50-60% raw diet, then your parameters, whether it is blood sugar level, whether your blockages, whether your blood pressure, it should naturally come down within a 4-5 days time. Within 3 days, we have seen results that the blood sugar level comes down. So if your blood sugar level and the sugars, BP level and the sugar levels are not reducing, that means the diet has not been followed religiously. You should understand one thing, like before 1997, normal BP was 160 by 100. But with the continuous researches and the parameters, it came to 140 by 90. Then it was considered the normal blood pressure. Then now today's parameters, 120 by 80 is considered normal. And within next few months, maybe it can come 115 by 75. So who will be without diseases? The one who doesn't go for the checkup. And all these researches have come up. If you really want to look for authentic research paper, there is a Cochrane collaboration. This collaboration does not get its funding from the drug or the pharmaceutical companies. all the researches are funded by mostly by the drug companies. So the whatever the data, whatever the parameters they are reducing, that there's a vested interest. They want to sell their drugs. So we should be aware of that, and we should be tackling all the problems, all the ailments naturally. And the best way to follow the dietetic rectitude, and the more than 50%, 60%, your diet should be the raw diet. In my diet plan, today, I want to give, already I've given the complete diet plan, but if you want to jot down, I would like to give one or two suggestions for example, this BP, for high blood pressure, what you can do is boil 1/2 teaspoon of Arjun ki chhal ka powder milta hai. You can get it from Ayurvedic shop. Arjun ki chhal ka powder, 1/2 teaspoon, 1/2 teaspoon of gudhal, and you need to boil these together in 100 ml of water, 5 minute ke liye. And you then drink lukewarm, sip by sip, and repeat twice daily. I repeat, if you want to note down, 1/2 teaspoon of Arjun ki chhal ka powder and 1/2 gudal, and then boil them together in 100 ml of water for 5 minutes, and then sip, and then when it is warm, you need to sip it warm, and you can have it twice, early in the morning or with the before breakfast, and at the bedtime you can have that. This is also for BP patients. I want to recommend the massage of aloe vera gel. If you have aloe vera plant, you take out the pulp, you massage it on your head, and this is very effective for lowering the BP. Another thing is almond oil in your nostril. Put 4 drops of almond oil in your, it will not only take care of your BP, it will also take care of your migraine, headaches of any kind. And now for the diabetic patient, I would like to recommend you take 1/4 teaspoon of coriander seeds, which is dhaniye ke beej jo hote hai. 1/4 teaspoon of dhaniye ke beej, and methi, which is fenugreek, and jeera, which is cumin, and boil them together in 100 ml of water for 5 minutes. And that also you need to sip warm for the diabetic patient. So these you can inculcate in your diet, number one. And then you need to inculcate the diet plan, which I told you that start your day with any of this drink you can start. Start your day with your any eliminative drink, amla water, lemon water, and then you should go for whatever, like 600, 700, 500 to 700 grams of fruits of 3-4 kinds till 12 o'clock. If you adopt this diet plan, there is no chance that your BP, your diabetes, your sugar will not come down. I'm telling you, please start following. So this much amount of fruits of 3-4 varieties, this is the seasonal fruit, and you should have it. Papaya, guava is coming, and even the diabetic can eat the banana, no harm done. Consume lot of fruit till 12 o'clock. You should avoid drinking tea and all. Those who are used to, first have the fruit, then you can have your tea. I have also suggested the Pragya Pay and Arogya Pay. Have I posted the tea recipes now? Herbal concoctions I have posted. You can replace the frequency of that normal tea with those herbal concoctions, right? So this much amount of fruit, if you are regularly having, then when it comes to the meal time, you can have 250 to 300 grams, rather 300 grams minimum, you should have raw salad. Cucumber. When you will, you should by now have bought a kitchen scale. one cucumber is this much, is 100 grams. So one or two cucumber and tomatoes, it will make your 300 grams, 250 to 300 grams of salad, onions, and whatever you like, whatever you can eat raw, capsicum, or whether it is whatever seasonal vegetables are coming, they can be eaten raw. You should start your meal first consuming that much amount of vegetables, and then you eat whatever you like, whether you like chapati, whether you like rice. Enjoy your food, eat what you like, but the only thing is you need to consume the salad first, and they should be taken simultaneously. First you eat, finish the salad, and there shouldn't be any gap between the two. Start your meal with the salad, and then you take your favorite thing, whatever you like. If you are fond of chapati, if you are fond of rice, even that is no harm will be done. So that is the sequence of the dinner as well. So I have given soup, salads, but if you are fond of chapati or dalia or vegetable dalia, you want that, consume that much amount of salad first. Now, for snacking throughout the day, if you are hungry in any time of the day, you should consume lot of sprouts. If you are not fond of raw sprouts, you steam cook it. Put lots of keera, tomato, and all the onions, and make it a squeezed lemon juice. A beautiful chaat is made, and you can consume that. Fruit by midnight, whenever you are hungry, fruit anytime you can eat. And the soaked dry fruits, I have mentioned the soaked dry fruits with the coconut shavings in it. You can drink that. And then these concoctions which are pragya pe, that you can drink any part of the day. So these are the choices. And what you need to, why I'm talking about so much of raw diet, because see, our heart is just 250 grams, right? But our all the arteries and the capillaries combined together, if they are combined together and laid side by side, it will make 1 lakh kilometers of that is the length of all the arteries, capillaries, veins joined together. So how does a heart so small can pump blood in the entire system? How it can generate that amount of pressure to deliver and for the circulation? For the proper circulation, our body, nitric oxide, the presence of nitric oxide, which is secreted by the walls of the arteries, that is responsible for the push, for the circulation. And this nitric oxide is found in abundance in raw fruits, vegetables, sprouts. So the more you eat, the more your circulation is unhampered. There will be no chances of accumulation of toxins or clogging or clot will be formed. So this is the reason your diet should be majorly, mostly for more than 50%, 60%, it should be raw diet. That you should keep in mind. Another very important thing which the raw diet or the uncooked diet, see, the cooked diet is good. It will give you energy. But the reparative mechanism which your body needs, that is present only in the raw form of the food. These raw food, they are life, full of enzymes. And what are enzymes? Our body has thousands and lakhs of enzymes, each food item. And these enzymes are responsible. No matter how nutritious food you eat, how full of vitamins, minerals, and very good diet you are having, but if it is not having the necessary amount of enzymes, the absorption, the assimilation of that food will not. It will go down through your stool, out of your system. and your body will not be able to assimilate that the nutritive quality of that food. So you need to understand, the more the raw food, the more these enzymes are there, and they do all the action of the digestion, of the absorption, assimilation, and all the metabolic activity, all the actions, reactions, chemically, whatever are taking place, these are due to the presence of enzymes. And after a certain degree, when they are, the food is heated to more than 50 degree, then they start getting sluggish. The activity of enzymes gets lower and lower. They are then, after, if you continuously or heat again and again your food, then the these enzymes, they die off and they lose their ability. So this we need to understand. Another important thing I want to bring your attention is, stay away from supplements. Sometimes some people say you are deficient of vitamin C or D or whatever. So these synthesized supplements, they don't work in a way they are expected to work. Because suppose if we take a vitamin C supplement, you will take inside, it will affect the copper vitamin, and the deficiency of copper will occur. With the deficiency of copper, the iron toxicity will occur. Iron is less in the blood, poor absorption will result, and the poor utilization of all the minerals and vitamins. So there will be an imbalance in the biochemistry of your body, because they are synthesized form of a supplement. Whereas when you take these varieties of fruits in your diet, variety of vegetables in your diet, each and every fruit and vegetable have different amount of minerals and vitamins. These are made by nature, and our body is made by nature. So our body knows how much amount of that nutrient is required by our body, and that amount is taken by our body and absorbed. So there is a balance, there is a harmony, and the nature knows whatever is packed in the natural form, the body assimilates it, takes it in the quantity whatever is required. And also these synthesized supplements, they enter the system and they harm the cell, because they take a lot of effort in entering the cell. In that process, they damage the cell. Whereas these natural supplement, the natural vitamins and minerals which we derive from the natural sources, they act like an umbrella. Like the umbrella, they squeeze while entering the cell, and then they open up when they have entered the cell. So no harm is done to the cell of any kind, and the nutrients and the no deficiency can ever occur. Mind you, no deficiency can be fulfilled by supplements. Never. It's not possible. And no deficiency will occur if you take variety of fruits, vegetable, inculcate that in your diet. So what are the foods you need to avoid? You need to avoid the packaged good, the whatever is refined, whether it is refined salt, refined sugar, refined wheat or cereals, oils, and you should take, see, if the sugar, white sugar, it looks beautiful, but it is chemically treated and it is literally poison. And for assimilating that in our body takes calcium from our bones. So it is not only difficult for our system to digest, but also it depletes our system from the calcium which our bones have. Salt. For making the salt free flow, it is chemically treated. You should go for rock salt, and which is not chemically treated, and which is in the form of rock. So go for the Sendha Namak, the Lahori Namak, whatever is available, instead of the free flow salt. and then the wheat and all, when the packaged wheat and these things we eat, they are all, the nutrients are removed. The wheat bran is, the company is selling for separately. Wheat germ is, which is the most precious and most nutritive part, is sold for exorbitant prices. And so the most important nutrients are removed by the companies and they are sold for exorbitant prices. And what we get in the atte ki thali, it's pure, like it's lack of nutrients is there and all the nutrients are gone. So I'll recommend ke chakki ka aata, mota aata, jo hai, that is good for your chapati. It will provide the necessary bulk to your diet, and it will act as a jhadu in your intestine and cleanse it. And remember, the accumulation of toxins is the root cause of all the diseases. So this fiber, the white, this water is necessary for flushing out the toxins. Animal food, you should keep away from animal food, because research has proved time and again, our intestines are not meant for the non-veg. And in this day, this animal products, I want to mention the milk also. Today, the milk is not really the milk. You will say ki hamare to jo hai purvaj hai aur doodh dahi ko kitni mahatva tha, but उस जमाने में सबसे पहली बात कि जो हम दूध इत्यादि पीते थे तो उतना पैदल मीलों चलते भी थे, फिजिकल एफर्ट भी करते थे, तो वो चीजें हम इजीली डाइजेस्ट कर पाते थे, पचा पाते थे. आज की सेडेंटरी लाइफ में नो फिजिकल वर्क इज देयर, सो देयर इज अ दिस, वी आर नॉट एबल टू डाइजेस्ट एंड एब्जॉर्ब, एंड इट creates the toxic environment in our system. And also, the research has proved in Finland, Denmark, and many other countries where the milk consumption is more, there are more cases of osteoporosis and bone diseases. Once you drink the milk, the acidic, as we say, our blood is alkaline. So our body tries to maintain that alkalinity. But when we drink milk, the acidic condition of the body increases. Now the body tries to normalize it by taking the calcium. And when the calcium is finished from the food intake, this body takes calcium from the bones. This is the highest kind of leaching. That's why the more dairy, milk, and all this consumption in the countries where it is occurring, more bone diseases are happening there. So this is the thing. Now I would like you to please you follow the diet plan, because that is the only way. And then you monitor your sugar. If by your BP is like 160 by 100, regularly. Rajiv ji, I would like to know what is the status of your BP. Could you please tell me what is your current BP? Yeah.
Good morning.
Yeah.
BP jo hai wo kafi high chal raha hai. I don't know what is the reason, because as I told you earlier, ki beech mein ek aisa time aa gaya tha 2 3 4 mahine jab kafi low ho gaya tha. It reached up to 55 60 by 1995. So it is 160 by 95. Just abhi do bar maine check kiya before yoga and after yoga. So around 157 by morning it was around 160 by 95. Now it is 157 by 85.
Okay.
So, but I am taking regular morning fruits, 600, 700 grams, soaked nuts, juice, uska cucumber or peta jo hai, and lunch well.
Yeah, lunch. Acha, aap green leaves bhi inculcate kare apni diet mein. Green juice, like you can inculcate in your diet, which is like a handful of dhaniya and pudina and 10 kadi patta. blended with water. This also is like कभी आपके कहीं आप देखिए कि कहीं चोट लगती है उसपे ग्रीन जूस आप किसी भी पत्ती का डालेंगे इट विल हील सो बॉडी के अंदर. Have you got yourself checked for KFT kidney function test? Sometimes the
recently किया था around maybe three months back.
Okay, so it's normal.
Normal.
Okay, so ये BP की जब आपकी समस्या शुरू हुई तब से ही आपका ये इतना ही रह रहा है या अच्छा आपने बताया बीच में कम भी हुआ है?
वैसे तो मेरे 2004 से BP था और मैंने regular medicines ले रहा था. बट अराउंड मार्च अप्रैल मतलब जब ये कोविड स्टार्ट हुआ उस समय जब मैं घर पे मैंने अपने आप को थोड़ा सा स्टेबल किया फूड एंड एवरीथिंग तो मेरा बीपी लो हो गया काफी तो वो इतना लो अराउंड 60-65 बाय 90-95 तो मैंने मेडिसिन छोड़ दी. तो पिछले दो महीने से मैंने मेडिसिन छोड़ी हुई है. सो नाउ आई एम नॉट टेकिंग एनी मेडिसिन व्हिच आई वाज टेकिंग फॉर ऑलमोस्ट व्हाट 15-16 इयर्स एनी बीपी मेडिसिन. बट पिछले कुछ 7-8-10 दिनों में बीपी थोड़ा हाई चल रहा है. आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज द रीजन.
अच्छा व्यायाम में कपालभाति इत्यादि तो नहीं कर रहे आप?
नहीं कपालभाति मैं नहीं कर रहा.
कुछ भी आपको ध्यान रखना है रिग्रेस नहीं करना है आपको. और उस दौरान जब आपका बीपी इतना डाउन आया था तब आपने डाइटरी मॉडिफिकेशन या तब क्या किया था?
डाइटरी मॉडिफिकेशन किया था और लाइफस्टाइल चेंज हुई थी इसीलिए शायद बीपी डाउन हुआ था.
एग्जैक्टली दैट्स माय पॉइंट कि आई एम सरप्राइज्ड कि अभी अगर आप वही लाइफस्टाइल डाइट और लाइफस्टाइल अपनाएं तो तभी नीचे आएगा. तो आप ये देख चुके हैं कि लाइफस्टाइल से और डाइट से सो गो विद दैट प्लान व्हाट एवर इट वॉज इट मस्ट बी लाइक मोर ऑफ द वेजिटेबल्स एंड फूड एंड फॉलो दैट डाइट. एंड रवि जी से पहले मैं एक बात पूछ लूं उसके बाद मैं आप दोनों के लिए एक बात कहना चाहूंगी बल्कि सभी पार्टिसिपेंट्स के लिए इन द एंड. यस रवि जी हाउ आर यू सर? हाउ आर यू?
आई एम ओके. मैं सब नॉर्मल मेंटेन कर रहा हूं मैं.
वेरी गुड. और डाइट फॉलो कर रहे हैं सर?
मैं ये डीआईपी डाइट जो है वो फॉलो कर रहा हूँ.
हाँ वही है. आई हैव बीन प्रिविलेज्ड टू वर्क विद डॉक्टर बिसरूराज चौधरी. आई हैव वर्क्ड विद हिम सो मोस्ट ऑफ लाइक आई टेक थिंग्स फ्रॉम हिज रिसर्च आल्सो फ्रॉम अदर नेचुरोपैथी आल्सो एंड आई कंबाइन देम एंड दैट्स द वंडरफुल वे टू कंट्रोल योर शुगर एंड बीपी एंड एवरीथिंग. टुडे आई हैव गिवन यू टू ऑप्शंस फॉर वन फॉर दिस हाई बीपी एंड वन फॉर द डायबिटीज द कंकॉक्शन यू शुड ब्रिंग एंड ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट सी what is health? Health is happiness inside. So we need to be healthy inside because no matter how good food we eat, no matter how well we exercise, but if we are not able to calm the inner storms and inner stresses, we are not able to do that, then we cannot remain healthy. And what is the best way to be happy inside? Is to nourish your mind. Find out whatever is joyful to you. Listening to old songs, yeah, playing some music, doing painting. Find out some hobby that nourishes you from your mind. So you should engage yourself in something which by doing which you lose track of time. जो अपने मनपसंद का काम जब आप कर रहे थे तो time का पता नहीं चलता ना कि कैसे घंटे निकल गए. और तो उसको आप पैशन को जो है रिवाइव करें और ताकि वो जॉय जो है वो आपको जो है सारी दवाइयों से सारे रोगों से मुक्ति दिलाएगी. एंड सबसे बड़ी बात हेल्प एनीबडी. इफ यू विल हेल्प समबडी इफ लव इज यू गिव अवे द लव विल कम बैक. इफ यू कंपैशन इज व्हाट यू गिव अवे द कंपैशन विल कम बैक. This is the law of nature. So if you want to be happy, just make somebody who is unhappy, chahe aapke ghar mein, do something and you will be happy. That is the golden rule. So with these words, I would like to end this session. And worries ko to nikal ke phek dijiye. Aur marna to ek din hai hi. Har din kyon mare? हर दिन क्यों इतना चिंता करें, राइट? सो ट्राई टू, अब देखिए ये कोरोना ने तो क्या क्या सिखा दिया है कि सच अ अनप्रेडिक्टेबल लाइफ इज, क्या क्या देखने को और क्या क्या लाइफ स्टाइल हो गया, किसी ने सोचा था क्या कि ऐसा भी हो सकता है? सो वाई वरी? द ओनली थिंग इज, ओनली कॉन्स्टेंट इन लाइफ इज चेंज. सो बी प्रेजेंट टूडे. कल क्या होगा उसके बारे में ना सोचे, कल क्या हो गया उसके बारे में ना सोचे, जो बीत गई सो बात गई, आगे क्या होगा किसी को नहीं पता. लिव इन द मोमेंट, एंजॉय द मोमेंट, दैट इज द की फॉर हेल्थ. सो इफ देयर इज एनी क्वेश्चन, मोस्ट वेलकम. एंड सो वी वाइंड अप एंड आई होप टू सी योर बीपी गोइंग डाउन मिस्टर राजीव. एंड रवि जी, I want to see the happy faces, the smiling faces, and the joy inside you. That the key to that is only with you. Nobody else will. You have to, like, the happiness is inside. Just find it and live it. This is life, right? So thank you, and have a wonderful day. And bye bye.
Much. Thank you.